Yes guys, welcome to another vlog for JDN Brickwork. We're starting here in Featherstone at the extension that you saw right at the very start when Shady were in the footing in that corner, Silky were over there and we were just bringing it up to DPC. You did see a little snippet in the last vlog where I took some independent little bits of the roof complete and everything like that, but now Ben's here so you can get some proper detailed footage of this and you can see the almost finished product. We're just waiting for Alfie to come here to build a little buttress wall to hold the middle pillar up on the inside, and then build the honeycomb sleeper wall along the middle for the joiner to put the floor on tomorrow. And then after that, our part on this job is done. We'll pass it back to the client for him to do his two little knock-throughs, which I'll explain a little bit more about in a second. And then he can get his first fix done, get it furnished, and he's away then. We need to do a little bit more, a little bit of snagging. There's some bits of pointing inside that have been missed, and a little jet wash on the external skin of brickwork. As you can see behind me, we've got a little bit of a scaffold rash going on, so that needs jet washing off. And then once that's done, we're done, this job's done and out of our air, and it's been a pleasure to share it with you guys. Then once that is done, we're going to head over to Pickhill to catch up with the boys. Shady, Silky and Charlie are over there taking care of taking plot 9 and 10 up to wall plate, so they shouldn't be far away. The trusses are going on there next week and then it will be the cut up. So the next time that we catch up with you guys, you should see the Pickhill job all done. Maybe not the full job. You'll see plot 9 and 10 on Pickhill all done. Then once we've been to Pickhill, we're going to head over to Roundy in Leeds to see a fresh footing that we started on Monday, which is well on its way. It's a big wraparound extension, so the footing's taken a while. We've come across a few little issues that I'll explain when we get there as well. And yeah, that'll be just about it for this episode. And I think Alfie's arrived just in time. Yes. Starting, bro.
Haven't seen Alfie in a while, have we, on this?
Let's all congratulate Alfie. Completed his apprenticeship, all past distinction and merit, is it not? Yeah. And we've got a little surprise for Alfie as well. I've got him a little present that I'm going to send to Ben now for him to show you, because by the time this episode comes out, Alfie will have it in his hand. Until then, he's not going to know what it is. You guys are probably going to see this before Alfie. So yeah, Alfie, let's get cracking. Sleeper wall, honeycomb. Your joist.
Yes.
I think it might be three. Yeah, because the top of joists here, and we've got 100mm joists and 22mm chipboard.
Might be four.
If this was a finished concrete floor, we'd have had it polished and floated and new and a lot, but it's just an oversight. So we've got that, and then we've got as void, then as timbers, then as floor. So I've graph gun in this as well for what it was. We had 15 ton of hardcore going under this, and then 100mm concrete. We've got Alfie's sleeper wall that he's going to build today, and the joists, and that'll be his floor done, as I've previously mentioned. So let's get the mixer out of the van, get you that cement round, and then you can crack on, mate. Ooh. That'll do for intro, won't it?
Yeah, yeah, it was nice. Straight off the bat.
Straight off the bat.
As always.
One take.
One take king, you lad, aren't you?
Is that what we are, one take king?
Yeah.
We take pride in keeping it real, don't we?
Yep.
It is what it is, and it ain't what it ain't. Let's go.
Need like one of trolleys from beach.
Right,
Alfie,
it's 4 course, mate.
Well, it's 4 course. Mm-hmm. Alfie was right.
Alfie was right. One like Alfie. Yep, bang on, up 44, so. 11mm joint, see if it's like one there.
Mate, listen,
look at
another problem and all,
Go on.
Yeah? It's nearly on red,
mate,
but we've got no
telecam
at all.
Alright.
So, what's crap?
Let me give you this Shams number, because I'm going to be over there for another hour or two.
Yeah, well, will you call and get someone?
Yeah, he'll sort it out, yeah.
Oh yeah, alright, mate.
Has it run out fully, or is it?
It's nearly on red, isn't it, John? yeah, nearly on red, mate, yeah.
Nearly on red. So it's not on red yet, so you can still use it for a bit.
Yeah.
Alright, cool. I'll pass this number now.
Alright, brother.
Right. Remember during the outro on the last episode where I had a conversation with that man there about starting? Well, they started on the following Monday and he's been mint since, so it's going very well.
see if he can...
Will we see him today?
We will be seeing him today, yes.
Nice. I think last time...
Seen him before?
Yeah, last time he was in any of the series when he had full hazmat suit on.
Yeah, that's it.
Bum, bum.
Yeah, well. Come on,
bum. What's he going off in here, lad?
You know.
What are you doing here, then?
See over there, all that block work were done overhand, so it was difficult to point it as we went along. It just kind of got whipped up. We pointed the cavity side, but we've got to also fill the inside here so that when the inspector comes, he doesn't assume that there's a straight, that there's gaps in the block work. So we'll get that parged up and pointed up before it gets first fixed and plastered for him. Knock through and layout, etc. So the buttress wall that Alfie's going to build today, hopefully, is going to go one block pillar, obviously tied into here, and on that here, it's about central. So that little buttress is going to go there just to make sure that this don't go anywhere, and then the client's going to build a stud wall coming off of the buttress into there once that window's blocked up as well. And that's going to partition these two new rooms, so that's going to be a kitchen diner, so we're going to knock through there, make this like an opening for the dining room, and then the new kitchen's going to be in there, and then that's going to be a lounge where there's going to be a little doorway coming here, just cut down here underneath this window. There's going to be a door coming from the inside out into the lounge. As you can see, where our new brickwork here meets the old brickwork there, this existing bungalow were a bit jaggedy and topsy-turvy and all over the shop. So instead of what we sometimes do is, if it's just a slight discrepancy, we'll pin into the existing and go across to the corner. But with this one, because it was so far out, mismatched gauge all over it, we're in and out, going up the reveal as well, we decided to just keep our brickwork bang on plumb. Same with that corner there, bang on plumb, so it all lines through nicely. Because after speaking to the client and finding out that this is where he wanted the downpipe anyway, the downpipe is going to come down from the outlet that you can see up there coming out of the guttering. It's going to bend across there, and the downpipe's going to come down the straight joint, so it's going to be covered up anyway, so you'll barely even be able to tell unless you come right up to it and have a good look down, and you'll be able to see a little lipper on the straight joint. But this is the straight joint that's connecting the new with the old with the starter ties, and like I say, the downpipe's going to be covering it up, so that is the best of a bad situation, really. These are some of these old houses moved. Oh, pink drink.
Did it have more white?
No white ones. What about the gold one, the pineapple one? Don't have any of them either.
What flavour is that?
This is a punch, monster punch energy, I feel.
Are you not right into them? I've got a watermelon in my car for your driver's swap.
Do you want
to
swap?
What
is it? Is it the red one?
Yeah.
The zero one?
Yeah.
Swapsies?
Yeah. So I've never had this one.
Nice one. Alfie loves them. Cheers, though, Alfie.
Dambo left it in my car, so.
Benji's going to have that. I'm going to have his red one.
Yeah.
He's off to America, isn't he? Oh, cheers, bro.
What?
Switch. Oh, it's still nice and cold.
Yeah.
Yeah, beautiful. Cheers, Ben.
Nice and watermelon ones.
Yeah, I love them. We've had some nice comments comparing us.
To who?
No, just saying, obviously, Daniel Ashfield has got a full camera crew going around with him all day, every day. But obviously, at our level, we haven't got the capabilities or the feasibility to do that, but he's going to America, isn't he? I think he's going to be in a film or something.
Is he, yeah?
Some mad acting thing, so I'm not sure how he's going to do that. Maybe he'll just have the guys there on site.
Yeah.
Kind of getting some bits with the managers and stuff. He's got a few managers working for him. Big Tezza. Tezza will probably be holding the fort while he's away. Be interesting to see what he gets up to. And that is not a plug. I'm just a bit of a fanboy. Hey?
That Tezza will be a right whack.
Tezza? He's going to right whack anyway. People saying he's underpaid and no one even knows what he gets what he gets paid. But hey ho. Enough about Daniel. Back to JD.
Right, who's Tezza?
Said enough about Daniel, back to JD. Tezza is probably the shady here.
Oh, right hand man, totally.
On another level, obviously, there. He looks after operations when the man's not there.
Yeah.
Looks after all the lorries and stuff, I believe. I can't really say much more without sounding like a complete creep.
No, there's no wrong with that, lad.
Yeah, Tezza. Big Tezza. Seems like a nice guy. En route now to the latest extension that we started. This is the dig that I was telling you about during the intro, where we're starting a fresh new extension. It started on Monday. This is going to be a big wraparound extension, single story at the back and a double story on the side. We've pulled a subby in called John to dig the foot in the machine. Very good digger driver. We'll be catching up with him in a minute. He's pulled the foot in, sorted the oversight out. We've got the outhouse building demolished. and we're just going to go catch up now to see how this dig is getting on. This is the last day that we've got John. We've had him since Monday. Today is Wednesday, and he's moving on to another job tomorrow, so this dig needs to be done today. The inspector's been out. He's very happy with how it's progressed so far. We've got to good ground. We've hit some clay. We're about between 1.5 and 1.6 metres deep from existing ground level, so it's a fair depth. It's just about the limit as well for what this machine that we've got can reach. So yeah, very good progress so far on the dig this week. We're going to just catch up, and oh my gosh, that is some mound of mud there. I hope we can get another grab load in before the end of today. But how things have gone this morning with the grab that was supposed to be here at 11, turned up 2 hours late, it's not looking promising. So we will assess. I don't know, did I hit something then? We will assess the situation. No, we'll diesel. We'll catch up with John. Yes, there's diesel, it's there, Jericho. We'll catch up with John, catch up with the boys that have been on this job since Monday, and see how we get on. I'm on this job for Sham. We had a grab deal booked in at 11 o'clock, mate. It's still not been.
Yeah, I did tell Sham. 20 to 2.
Not do it at
11 o'clock. Yeah. I straightened the house straight away. Yeah. He's actually going to be there in about 2 minutes. I've just been on the phone with Sham now.
Yeah, I spoke to Sham an hour ago and he said he was 15 minutes away.
No, he spoke to my boss, John, and I've already been in touch with Sam and said he's on his way. He's on right. Beckett Street, does that make
Beckett
sense?
Beckett Street, yeah, that's not too far away. All right, thank you, mate.
Cheers, buddy. I'll be there in the morning to see the one, all right?
Yep, sound. Great. All right, cheers, mate. And breathe. All right, let's have a look at his footing.
If they're at full width, 600,
yeah.
Put them where your build's going, so they're under build.
Yeah. So we can just put us brick and block work on top of
yeah.
it. Just like two lintels.
Yeah. As soon as we told him it was 5 metres straight down that, that's what they come out with.
He's happy with ground and everything?
Yeah. Everything's sound. He's not coming back now until DPC.
Happy days. And he's happy that we put in 1.4.
I said, do you want any photos checking of it? He says, no, I've seen what I want to see.
Alright, bud.
Sorted.
Yeah.
Happy days.
Happy days when Port Minute Dig edit that there. Okay, alright.
What did you do?
I started it up. It threw him into there.
I hit that with my head.
And I looked at him over here and it spun me. Stay down there on his ass, man.
Right hand off.
Let's wait for health and safety police to have a word about that in the comments.
I couldn't move.
But you're alright, Portman.
Gotcha.
You're alright, yeah. He's one of them guys that just can't be killed.
I've just realised he's got a bit of a perm on him.
He got the perm. He didn't get the mullet.
I think he got the perm. What saved me, to be fair, when I went ding.
That's the man that were on the phone
during the last episode.
Yes, guys.
He's been here since.
Oh, for scaffolding, mate. They've had a bit of blow down. And scaffolding's bored like that.
Where's it?
Pickle.
Oh.
It's not been a great Tuesday. We've had a grab wagon 3 hours
he's
late.
He's been all right.
Had a bit of blow down at Pickle. We started digging, and then we came across the drain that you can see now. We discovered that pretty early on, and then we expected to find that drain running at a gradient of how drains usually run when we got to the other side, and it was nowhere to be seen. So because we're tapping into that with the new top water pipe, we were thinking where we're going to be able to tap into this. We're not going to be able to go down where it shows on the drawing because there's no pipe there. So we ended up getting the CCTV guys out to have a look at the drains and inspect them properly, and we discovered that the pipe drops somewhere about here, something like that, down 8 metres. If we were to keep digging and trying to find that pipe, we'd probably be wearing a cork hat and putting some shrimps on the barbie, because we are not digging that deep to find a pipe. So what we're going to do is just bring it around the side and track it in and put it into the pipe there that you can see where the existing stench pipe is. Just make it, they're happy for us to do it as a mixed waste, so that's like foul water and top water. They're happy for us to do that, so that makes our job nice and easy. We can just stick it into that clay pipe down there. CCTV guys, when they come with a camera, that just solves everything. They can see everything. They just literally stick a camera down, rod it, and you can see the depth, you can see where it tees off, what angle it tees off at, where it goes down in the street and everything. So that was a big help and a step in the right direction to help us move forward on this job. As Portman's just told us, the inspector's also specified some steel to go over that drain pipe rather than some concrete lintels, which we would usually use. Slightly odd, and
questionable, but we've got to do what he says because he's the man who gives us that tick at the end of the build to say everything's been done to his satisfactory standard. But he's very happy with the ground condition. He's happy for us to mass fill the footing with concrete. So we're going to put 1.4 metres of concrete in, which totals between 17 and 20 cube all the way around. So that's going to get poured on Friday with the pump, because that would be a lot of wheelbarrows if we were to barrow that in. That's a lot of concrete, 1.4 metre mass fill. Then we'll bring it up to ground level with some dumpy blocks, and then we'll go from ground level up to DPC with brick and block work as standard. And then we'll leave that as it is, ready for the oversight to be poured, because this is going to have a timber floor similar to the one we've just seen in Featherston. But all in all, the building inspector is very happy. A couple of delays with the grab wagon, but no major issues or major problems. We're just about there with the dig now. John ain't got long left in that digger, and if the grab wagon comes now, then we have a clear space on the drive for all the material to be dropped on Friday afternoon after the concrete's been poured. So this project is moving very smoothly, it's going very well, and we will be keeping you guys updated heavily with this project, because it's a very meaty extension. It's going to be a great build for you guys to keep up with.
Hey, knocker.
What?
You were like this, you were like that, I looked up here, why you put me like that? Same thing, you already know.
I figured out how to zoom in and focus.
I've here. Cracked it.
Just about. We're doing the best out there.
Not really.
2.5 hours late. To be fair, the man was very apologetic. We've had a delay on a job this morning, and then they had a couple of cancellations, and then some other local bits came in, so we got put on the back burner, but they're here now. Thank you, Allied, for eventually turning up. We will leave it with no hard feelings, and we will continue to do business together.
We'll just slag you off on YouTube a little bit.
We'll just give you a little bit of shit. But...
that claw.
Who's in charge here?
That claw.
So whenever they built this in 19 BC, looks like they just dug a big channel, stuck the drain in, and just covered it all up with concrete. So inspector's happy for us to just shutter his concrete off where you can see them red marks. Concrete up to that, and then we're going to put two steel girders over, acting as lintels, same as what I expect for that little one over there that you've just seen. It's always a good sign when client comes out with a tray full of coffees, some sugar cubes, we're just missing some rich teas, and we'd be on to a winner. Cheers, Steve. We've had a bit of milk, look for it, boys. Thank you, mate.
No worries. I don't need to go to the hairdresser.
Super cool hero.
There you go, that's me then.
You look very funky today, Ben. Is that a Nike skin top?
Yeah.
And then an eagle.
Yeah, Obey, no jumper, in fact.
Oh, okay.
But I've had it for years, look at it.
Yeah.
It's just ideal for your jobs, isn't it?
Yeah, we've got some white, funky white pants.
There you go.
And as always, the white shirt. Oh, we're only joking, Steve.
No.
I said these coffees would be better with some rich teas. Just come out with a pack of biscuits, look. We're only messing, pal. Dig is done, inspector happy, client is happy. One grab load has come today, eventually, and we've got another two booked in back-to-back tomorrow morning to get rid of this big pile of muck behind me. So, as soon as that's gone tomorrow, we can get the material is ordered. The material's coming on Friday afternoon, so that should be timed perfectly for when the pour's done on Friday morning. So we're getting here at 7 o'clock Friday morning to prepare for the concrete. Concrete's in at 8. We should be a couple of hours doing the concrete in, and then the material's coming on Friday afternoon, ready for us to attack it on Monday. Very good progress with this job, as I've said. Everything's going nice and smooth so far. Touch wood, fingers crossed it stays that way. And the client and our client stays as happy as they are already with us. So yeah, very, very good start on this job. And I look forward to sharing more of the progress with you.
Everything.
Okay, it's like he's modelling for us.
You know, they do that, don't they?
Where to now then, lad?
Just pretend to be on the phone.
Pickle.
I think it'd be a bit stupid looking at the time to go to Pickle because we're going to get there at 3:30.
Yeah, it's quite late.
The boys will finish at 4 and then we've got another hour to come home, so
yeah.
We're probably going to head over to Colton. For now, we're going to run it back and we're going to show you all the footage that we got on the GoPro during this build. We've got some good bits. We showed lots of progress on this job on the GoPro. And while you're watching that, we're going to hit the road and head to Colton to show you the finishing bits. All right.
Call this brickwork.
Wow, wow, wow.
What
to
do,
no, what we've done so far?
Smack.
Absolutely.
Oh,
smacker jacked it. Oh, another one, look. Lovely. Bangers and mash. Dong dee dee dong dee dee dwee dwee dee 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 daw. Oh, would you look at that? Some gable.
That's what we've got to do to keep the lads in check.
Oh, mate, you actually, that's fine. I mean, you've actually got it out.
The noises are totally unnecessary, but. This is what we've got to do to keep the squad fit and healthy.
This is the world of JDN.
Look at that t-shirt.
Hey, hey, hey. I'm always providing the dunch. All the gear and no idea.
All the idea and no gear.
Get off!
How's your back, Silky?
Like a quaver.
Nice. Perfect. We plumb that up there. So we've got a nice plumb line all the way down. And then make us cuts in there. Just so it's all nice and neat look. Easy. We're gonna do a seawalk. You can't do a seawalk.
I've got more room.
Got more room now. What? 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 Oh!
It's all about making that GTA, cause the boys in the hood always high.
Fire on the scaff.
In the trash, they'll pull your car. Knowing nothing to like, but to be legit. Don't pull me, boy, cause I ain't say shit.
Yeah, yeah. Dope, man. Oh, you should have perked it to me.
Too fast.
Motherfucker, face. Tell my bees in the place, forgive me the place. You say my man JD is on three bays. The boy JD was a friend of mine till I caught him on the floor trying to steal it out.
I've used these timbers. Clamped them on. That'll keep them in place till the brickwork has gone off. Then we can take it off and it'll look spicy. Not sure what I've shown you then, I'm sorry. Yeah, what's that? Right shift.
Big old job this. This extension has a bigger floor plan than the actual bungalow itself. Is young Bailey doing something?
Cut his boots on today, not his running trainers. That's a joke for another, that's a story for another day.
Cause he's a runner, he's a track star.
What's that? Meatloaf.
It won't matter, hell, he'll be gone when the morning comes.
What?
So yeah, that's us done for today. The time is about 4 o'clock, 4:15.
Why has he got his trendy sunglasses on at work? Oh, the fucking pleb.
Has he?
This is Mitch, the main contractor's apprentice.
Is he a darling?
With some Fendi sunglasses on.
For work.
This man is an apprentice bricklayer.
Fendi sunglasses on? I'm doing something wrong, mate. I've got an SB Tools cap on, a lot of free gear from people who want to talk to us on Insta.
I ain't got my own boxes on.
And we've got young Mitch in some Fendis, haven't we?
What's that?
Young Mitch in his Fendi sunglasses.
Oh yeah, he's got some feeler fucking...
I can't even afford my own boxes.
I know, it's
not life. Silky's wearing old labourer's boxes.
What have I got on?
Why are you wearing old labourer's boxes, Silky?
So I shit myself at work.
No. Shit myself in the van at the customer's house.
We were working near the old labourer's house, and the old labourer said, it's all right, it's okay, I'll go home and get you some boxes.
And everyone said I was scruffy for it. 2 weeks later, Jim shit himself.
Oh, you bastard, you turned it off. No, I didn't turn it off. I think it still got it. Yeah. Yeah. What he said.
Outside McDonald's.
Luckily, I was near a McDonald's. I did have to spend the rest of the day. Commando. I'm sorry, YouTube or future clients. Yes, that is what you do.
Some bad breakfast.
That is what you're dealing with. That's what we get for eating shit every morning.
How do we get down?
Just need shade to pull himself now and then. Full gang's done it.
What did you say about them Fendi?
It looks shit. Cut's nearly done. We've got about another half an hour's work here. Get all this bull in here. Get the sun, the top hat on. Sun has got his hat on. Don't know. I think he's getting to me today, to be honest. Just need to get this in. Finish them cuts. What Shirley's done a splendid job of down there. We're going to continue them all the way up this pink string line that you can see. And then we're going to get us lined back onto these two lats. One up here. There's another one down at the bottom. We're going to get that line back on. As you've seen in a previous episode, how we do cut ups. I'm going to just finish these cuts off. Get this in. And if we've time, we're going to get to the pub.
Is that the final one?
It's the final cut. Da 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 do. Da 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 do. Da da do. But as I was saying, the sun has got his hat on. Beep, 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 hooray! The sun has got his hat on and you're getting walled today.
Oh no.
So we fast forward 2 months on from that footage that you've just seen. Taken by ourselves on the GoPro while Ben weren't here, and this is what we're left with, the finished product. Now we obviously only did the brickwork on this job, but we thought it'd be cool to come back and show you the finished product, all completed by Rob at Rob Young Building. Rob's a fantastic client. He keeps going with a lot of work, gives us a lot of shells and extensions and stuff like that, so we're very grateful to him. And this is the finished product, what you're left with, which included work from ourselves on the brickwork. And if I do say so myself, the brickwork does stand out a lot and looks very, very well done. So big well done to the boys that were on here, Shady, Silky, Alfie, Bailey at the time, jumping in on the mixer. We've got a cool little swing corner around the side there, and a couple of features, soldier courses, and a challenging brick to keep clean. But I think Rob might have jet washed it down a couple of times, but looking at it now, it does look very, very neat and very well put together. So this room here is formed into a new bedroom for this client. So they've gone for, obviously, as you can see, a patio door there and a funky little window coming up off the side, which is halfway up the total height. And then the other side, where you can see the big bifolding doors with the humongous soldier course that never seemed to end on top of the steel, that's formed part of the big open plan kitchen that Rob has knocked through on the inside. So now the existing kitchen has come all the way out to where these doors are and is now a massive open space. So we've come obviously down here, done the big statement cut up there, little dog leg down here, keeping the bricks all consistent and neat. And here we've done the squint corner, which took a little bit of time, but Shady did a very nice job of doing that corner very well, brick and the block work here. And then we've come down here, down the tight gap that you've just seen lots of footage from the GoPro on. It comes round in a funky shape, if you notice, that squint corner just sends it all on skewy. And then we come down on that squint corner, right angle back down this left hand side, and then back in to form the complete full extension. This underneath the window, we toothed that out and left it so that we could have access in and out while we were building. And then this little panel here with the last job to be done. Well, when everything could done on the back and everything, we kind of worked our way out. And then just to finish things off, we just built this back up to form the window, opening and that with that. I think that one that you've just seen us dig out, that's roundy. I think that'll probably, when that's done and complete, that'll probably be the biggest floor plan that we've actually done ourselves.
Yeah.
But yeah, this is up there. We love it. We just love it.
I think it needs some steel noises on this.
Well, we've got this text from Tom Bristol saying they're not letting you play the other 95 song anymore because of what you did to it.
Yeah, pretty much. Don't wind her up. We enjoyed it. The BBC canteen is a marvel place. It's very special. Where else?
This is to allow airflow because it's a timber floor.
Right.
We need airflow coming through the existing, because the existing joist from that way and our new joists are going to run that way, so them holes in between the bricks and our airflow to come from the existing, the non-existent air bricks. One air brick. Anyway, this is to allow airflow to come through underneath the timbers and then out of the air bricks that we've put in there.
What's the point in the flow coming through?
What's the point in air coming through?
Yeah.
To stop for bad smells and stenches and stuff like that.
Alright.
Underneath the timber.
What, like this? Started off disappointing but delivered in the end.
That was some effort. Let me check your pants. I'm very rarely speechless, but I'm speechless.
Already,
yeah, let's rip it, lad.
Alright, that's it for another episode, guys. We're back here in Featherstone where we started off. We've caught up with Alfie, we've seen him making good progress on this honeycomb wall. Bit of an head scratcher, but he's done a very good job so far. Say it's his first attempt, and that is going to provide a nice solid wall for the 100mm joists to sit on once the joiner comes and installs them tomorrow. So we've caught up with the dig, that is all done now in Roundy. Like you've seen, the concrete's coming for that on Friday, so we made very good progress on there this week. We're going to get some concrete in on Friday that hopefully we're going to get some footage of as well for you to see next time. And that is that, guys. Remember to like, remember to comment, remember to click on subscribe if you're watching and you haven't already, and let's watch this channel grow. Thanks again, guys. We'll see you on the next one.